Shalom, Chavarim. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Of course, today we are hearing already G20 summit in Hamburg, Germany. President Trump, President Putin will be meeting there on the sidelines of the G20 summit there to discuss, according to Rex Tillerson, Syria and what their plans are. Now, before I go into the Sputnik cast here, right here on the Russian language, they're already speaking about the Rex Tillerson has already stated basically what will be discussed in the meeting. And of course, it is Syria and the security of Syria and how that they must cooperate together to bring that about and safety on the ground, also including a no-fly zone over Syria. I don't think, though, that this is going to go the way that we would seemingly think it would be good for the Syrian people or that of President Bashar al-Assad. It seems like more to me that President Putin is going to be given an ultimatum by President Trump as to either go along with our plan or face war. And I don't think that President Putin is at any point at this time backing down on what he's planning on doing, as we can see that Putin seeks parliamentary approval to deploy warplanes in Syria. According to the report here on Sputnik News, says Russian President Vladimir Putin submitted on Thursday a protocol to an agreement with Syria on the deployment of Russian Armed Forces Aviation Group for the lower chamber of parliament's ratification. Yes, a little bit different the way that President Putin kind of addresses these things and then and that of former American presidents such as Bush, who doesn't even bother to get even Congress's approval, just go ahead and go attack a sovereign nation whether we like it or not. In this case, President Putin is following protocol of his own government there, getting the approval to be able to put more warplanes on the ground inside of Syria. And no doubt that is response to exactly what the U.S. has been doing that the Western media has not been reporting. 21st Century Wire reporting an article here by Vanessa Bealey. U.S. expands military footprint in Syria to 8 bases, modifies Kobani Air Base. 8 bases inside of a sovereign nation that doesn't want the United States present there at all. So who is the U.S. actually protecting inside the country? Well, for one, openly, they support the Free Syrian Army that is there to overthrow Bashar al-Assad in a sovereign nation. Unlike that of Russia, who is actually there to support the sovereign government elected by the people, and we even get comments and letters from those Syrians living inside of Syria stating to us that they support President Bashar al-Assad, especially the Christian community. I've even gotten them from Lebanon Christians, Lebanese Christians as well, saying that Assad should be the one that is supported in this country. Goes on to say here, Vanessa writes, the U.S. is setting up its military bases in the territories that were liberated from Daesh by our fighters during the fight against terrorism, senior representative of the U.S. Armed Proxy SDF Forces. With very little fanfare from the Western media, the U.S. is quietly creating a hostile military footprint inside of Syria by establishing a chain of air bases, military outposts, and missile bases inside Syria. The U.S. is illegally stealth occupying a sovereign nation. The number of U.S. military installations in Syria has increased to 8 bases, according to the recent reports, and possibly 9, according to one other military analyst. That's a major change that's happening inside of Syria. As we've been reporting to you now for 2 months about the U.S. advancement inside of Syria without any, not even UN authorization, just doing it because America can do it. And I love my country, but there's too many also. There's even politicians in America that are clearly against what we are doing. Ron Paul, for example, former senator, also blasting our presence inside of Syria. Even current politicians in the U.S. government there are blasting the fact that we're going into Syria uninvited. Of course, I guess if you are supporting a proxy war against the government, I guess you think you can do just whatever you'd like to do. But yet blame the gassing on Assad, make him look like the demon. And yet too many Americans have gone there did fact-finding missions, coming back to let us know that it's nothing but a propaganda war in American media to make us think that Assad is some kind of demonized guy, when in 2010, he was the very man stating that Israel has a right to exist, and that's supposed to be the reason why we're there in the first place, because of Israel, for Israel's protection. But Assad was our best bet for Israel's protection, even trying to work with Hamas, that is considered to be a terrorist group according to Israel. He was working with them to get them to recognize Israel's right to exist as well. Would have been our best chance for a peaceful solution inside of the nation of Israel today. But that all got thrown under the bus. Now, Vanessa Bealey, by the way, she is, we consider a friend of ours as well. She's been on RT on numerous occasions, exposing the white helmets, etc., and has her own website called The Wall Will Fall. And may, you may not agree with everything she writes, but she has done more exposure of what's going on in Syria with the U.S.-backed and British-backed white helmets, which basically equates to a terrorist organization. And this type of reporter, Vanessa Bealey, deserves the support of people from around the world. She's soon to go back into Syria once again to come back and let us know facts of things that are actually happening on the ground. On her own website here, thewallwillfall.org, and I'll put that here on the page here where you can see it there. You can actually donate to the cause that she's doing there. I encourage it. I don't hardly ever, in fact, I don't think I've ever spoke about supporting another journalist before, but Vanessa Bealey has really inspired us with her straightforward, candid reporting. I know not, like I said, not everything maybe I agree with her upon, but you know, neither does she agree with me on everything either. But we do have respect for at least that we're both trying to bring out the truth of what's going on in the world today. And she has done a remarkable job on that. So again, The Wall Will Fall. Take time out and show her your support as well. We would appreciate that and know she would as well. Also, again, I want to kind of go back, though, to the biblical aspect of this, Daniel 11, because of what Vanessa's latest report here coming out on the 21st Century Wire, the U.S. expands the footprint in Syria to 8 bases. We are really starting to see that prophecy there in Daniel 11 maturing. Of course, I think it's going to be an all-out invasion is what's going to happen, but this is only the beginning. Okay, and at the end shall the king of the south, and as I've taught you before, it's not push at him in Hebrew, it's emo, it's to push with him, the king of the north, Melech HaNegev, which is the king of the Negev desert, which is in Israel. Modern day Israel is the only place where you have the Negev. So the king of the south is the king of the Negev desert. All right, and of course it goes on to say, and the king of the south shall put it, and the king of the north shall come against him like a whirlwind, but not against him, but Aliyav, over him like a storm. I have a feeling, especially seeing as we are seeing the USS Bush, H.W. Bush aircraft carrier, the largest of its kind, has not been there in the Mediterranean off the coast of Israel in the last 17 years, has it been since this large of an aircraft carrier was deployed there with, gosh, what is it, 300 or 600? I forget the number, which number of aircraft is on board of this. You want to talk about being able to come over them like a storm. They definitely will come over. But of course, they come with the chariots and the horsemen. That wouldn't be done from an aircraft carrier, but no doubt maybe from the Incirlik Turkish Air Base or something of that nature there, or coming out of Italy, one of our U.S. bases there in Italy, when they would fly in, dropping in these Humvees, the soldiers paratrooping them down into there. If they get into a major conflict, that's what it'll be. They will come over him like a storm. So the king of the south, an Israeli leader, along with a hidden hand, because the word north in Hebrew is tzafon, which means hidden, not just north, but hidden. He is a hidden king, a very secretive king that runs the NATO military, runs the alliance, the British, the U.S. American military machines there. There's a hidden king that is doing that in the background. I cannot help but think that that is some kind of demonic being on the throne. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Shalom.